The first and foremost thing in your life has to be purity, divine purity. So how do you get purity? There are many ways to get purity, to create purity, and to increase purity. But the easiest way is to look at a flower and feel that flower is inside your heart. Nothing can be purer than a flower. You try to feel that flower is inside your heart, then afterwards you try to feel that the flower that is inside your heart has grown into your heart itself. Your heart itself has become the flower. Well, this is the flower. You can try also with a flame, candle flame. You see the flame before in front of your eyes, then try to imagine that flame is inside your heart, and afterwards try to feel that your heart has grown into the flame itself. So this way you can develop purity. Then comes patience. Now, you have children, and children are at times taking your patience away, you are being irritated. Now, just try to imagine a seed under the ground. This seed takes quite a few months. The farmer works so hard. He plows the ground, then waters the ground, then so many things he does in order to help the seed germinate. So after such a long time, you know, the seed will germinate, then it becomes a sapling, it becomes a tiny plant, tree, and flowers, then leaves, flowers, fruits. See, it takes years. Now, here you have to use the wisdom. If the farmer becomes impatient, why is it that the seed is not germinating into a plant in a day, in a two days or 3 days, and then what he'll do, he'll again unearth and take you the seed and throw it away. So here, while you are dealing with the children, also the little kids, you have to feel that they will grow with your patience. You want them, your dreams to be fulfilled in and through them. Give them time. Each time they do something, only show them compassion, more forgiveness. But wisdom has to act. If they are standing in front of a fire, there you know no compassion, there you have to take them away. But if they are, say, to some extent, disobedient, naughty, they try to show them with more compassion, more love, more affection. And at that time, to think of yourself. When you are a little child, perhaps you are of the same type or even worse. So nowadays I don't dare to scold I do scold, which is unfair, my spiritual children. I think I was quite notorious in the family, breaking up things, everything disobedient. So then my mother's patience did work. Now I've become perhaps a good person. So you see, my mother gave up. So his hopeless case, you know, family, undoubtedly I was, others were all calm, quiet, serene, and all that. I was the absolute the opposite. But my mother's patience worked, and see, I have far surpassed the rest of the members in my family in terms of spirituality. So here, and not only my mother's, my sister's, my brother's patients, they were all saints in my case. In my case, I was just outgoing, I was not of the same type. So I was in schools, these, that, absolutely the way. I used to turn the whole house topsy-turvy. So now, see, now I don't do that. That is all my mother's patients. So, and then, this is where walking along eternity's road. So, like the tree, it takes so many years it took for the tree to bear fruit, flower, this and that. But the farmer, or the The whoever gardener had boundless patience. Now God Himself is the eternal gardener in us. He has sown the seed of His divinity, His immortality in us. The way He is showing His compassion, His patience for us, we have to also, according to our capacity, show this. So according to our capacity, show affection, compassion, and patience to our own children, the way God is doing for us. So nothing can be done overnight. It takes time. So if we want to see the children to be fully illumined, fully perfect, then we have to start with them and grow in them with our constant compassion and constant patience. This is the only way we'll be able to see our dreams fulfilled in and through our children.